20 million euros, which makes resource this apart a class basis. But we must learn from these examples. Well, before I go any further, I think this is the best thing I can share with you, not designed by us. But this is something, it's a slate. This is designed by a lady, her name is Pragya, and she was born in Pune, Kothrud. After marriage, she went to Ahmedabad. She got married to Reed Bhatt, who works very soon. 18 years back, her son was born, Mehmoosh, and he was born totally visually challenged. He was born blind. And this is the gift of the stubborn to humanity. It's called as an action state. If you have seen brain books, what the visually challenged children, these are based on made of 6 dots, which are raised dots, because they can't see with their eyes, they feel with their fingers and the feet. This is Velcro, you know, 2 strips of nylon or loops, you know, the hooks, and you stick them together. This is only the hooks part, the loop part being discovered. So this is my drawing slate, and this is my drawing pen, which is essentially, it's like a fishing line. You make a crank line, then make a cycloscope into a Z shape, push the rubber down, down so the rubber makes space, and you can wrap some wood around. And you can see that here's a pen, there's a bit of a rubber. The purpose of the rubber is to join the pen to the plastic bottle. So it's like a fishing line. If I crank the handle, you can see the wood is getting wrapped up. And wood has a lot of fibers. And your fingers. You know the extent of life. Imagine the population of Mumbai. My friends come from Mumbai. It's about 13, 14 million. That's the extent of blindness in this country. Imagine being blind, Mumbai blind. This is the extent. There is institutionalized violence in society which makes the children blind. We're not able to give them vitamin A. Forget, we're not able to give them seriousness. Severe malnutrition in Pachamara, where I come from. This is the care. If you're not in your head, then that's in your belly, you know, you fight blindness. This is a challenge in this country. There are so many enormous challenges. One of our graduates who knocked up, especially Hindu, one of the proudest person in our batch. In the last maybe 30 years, there will be 1,500 engineers, bright engineers like you, who took part abroad because it's always been over there. But he's given challenges. There are neurons over here, you can think, you pass the analysis, there are challenges in this country to be solved. There are real problems, not phony problems, not virtual problems. There are real problems to be solved in this country. 1,500 engineers, this one man, because of his inspiration, he stayed back and done great work in this country. Well, we must give the person hero like us. She's the hero of a match. For me, he's the person hero because I suffered him for 5 years. Both you, Ashok and Arvind, and you both are entrepreneurs, so he was my I was not a match to him, but I think some of his enthusiasm got from him. So I owe a lot to Ashok. But this is something very, very powerful. This is when I worked in the parade, where I used to work, I retired about a month back, I worked in a treatment science center at IITK. IITK stands for the Indian University Center for Astronomy and Astrophysics. It was settled by India's most celebrated astrophysicist, Professor Jayakarthikan, Padma Bhushan. 20 years back, he got the Kalinga Award, which is the UNESCO's highest award for popular science. So when he set up this institute 25 years back, that this institute will offer a PhD in astronomy and astrophysics, he had sworn that we have a children's science. Because this is enlightened self-interest. If you want good scientists someday, you must imbue children with the love of science. One of his dear friends was Pula Deshpande. Anyone who is from Maharashtra would know about Pula Deshpande. The most iconic, the cultural icon of Maharashtra is Pula Deshpande. But he proved all that. 14 years back, he made a donation of 40 lakhs, personal money, for a children's science center. And that's where my two of my colleagues, one happens to be Dr. Vinda Meister, did a PhD 4 years in Stanford, postdoc, returned back, said, I just want to work for children. She worked for 7,000 days. She stuck around for 10 years because we celebrated every day. Our lives are very short. We think we're going to fool the world, but before that, we fool ourselves. Our lives are very, very short. And we must have enough to come in as well. Chances are very, very thin. You can pay to bread and do that. But human beings need much more than bread. They need something very basic out of their lives. So because these two, three individuals, very focused, very compassionate, we have about them so much. There are 5,500 books, passionate books on education, on the environment, on peace, anti-war, science, mathematics, and the great children's literature from across the world on my website. I've been to 3,000 schools in my country in 30 years. Every school I go to, most of the libraries are out. The children want to read, but the libraries are out. Now, technology enables us to share our passions for free. Every single day, 15,000 books are downloaded from this website. Many of the books I don't have permission, but they're 30 years old, 25 years old, out of print. Sometimes I get notices, you can infringe copyrights, and we negotiate it, we engage with it. But it's your book under your name, you never pay your rights. That's a simple pay your rights, it's a simple book, it's not relevant in our country for a lot of money. It has helped thousands of teachers, these are ours. Many people are kind across the world, they give us permission. Sometimes it's the enemies which give you a notice that you have to remove it, otherwise we remove it, but by the time 15,000 people have already downloaded it, our political task is over, we move ahead. And when they speak, we upload books, when they are away, we will be removed. So it's a good enough one. It is not an easy task, but 15,000 books are down. There isn't a publisher in Maharashtra which sells so many books. A small task and which we must invest. Well, one of the great spin-offs of us, and there was 100 books in Maharashtra. I can give Maharashtra, 35 years I've been in Pune. Marathi, the script is like my name, I can understand, I've been translating. I can't speak to fluently in Marathi. But 100 books we have here. There is a series by Asimov. In a few words, I saw us, but a third by Asimov. He wrote a series of books, 36 books for children. How do we find out about black holes? How do we find out about writing? It's a history of science. Fucking sick. All 36 have been from Marathi. Marathi happens to be the second language after English, the only other language. But there were 36 of us. Now this is the goodness. Hindi is far, 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 far. I've seen the poverty of Hindi for some very acutely. And one thing which I did more than that, I've translated 170 books into Hindi after my retirement on the 31st. I said that 26th January is a good day for us, and that's my target. So it was a 150 page book, very beautiful book, what is free from school by that proud and nice. It was written by a 16-year-old whose parents had taken him out of school and said that for a year, son, do whatever you want. Live your passions. Some people are as a gap here. This boy learned how to catch snakes from predator. He came to the snake park in Pune, learned about spiders. Vijay Lakshmi, who spoils the spider woman in India, learned about earthworms. And 16-year-old writing this amazing book. So we just call this book, please. You don't chase publishers because publishers are their own. Or, so you just make opinions and put it on it. For posterity, you may not be there, but this is, I was born a Hindu, but I do not know whether there is an Atma or not, but if there was an Atma, it's my website. Because who would gather the seven people? Even then, I'm not there. So this is a test. Inside the university, there is a Vidya Pariksha. One thing very shameful, in my view, all the professors send their kids to the Delhi public school, which is such a shame. Right, our best school, the campus school in our time was the best school. This is Meera Balasthas, before science activities became a fashion, she had written 5 books in 1970, Science in Action, 4 of them you can find on my website. Very amazing school, and they have let it die. Now, one of the links is closed last time, and I came 3 years back, you know, it's working half capacity because you can't, and they said they can't do the very public school, which is such a shame. You know, faculty, enlightened faculty, most of the PhDs that they got, for their own enlightened settlement with young kids, and they must go to a good school. So there's nothing, you're not going good to humanity. They're not able to organize, which is very, very shameful. inside the university. Put it in Rochester's 1 million, and they go to prison. It was a British government, someone has it, someone like would stand up for independence and convert this to the European university. That's the only green lung left, huge green lung left in the heart of the city. There is only one school in our campus, it's called the Vidya Piksha. I don't know why the Maharishi is doing Bharat Ratna, pioneer of women's education. This the only the downtrodden, the poorest people in the case. Not the Aimba faculty sent their children to Vidya Piksha, and it goes from bad to worse, because there's no accountability. This girl, and there is still hope. This girl, you get it, stays in a true property. Father is a drunkard, Mangu hai, roz aake maa ko peetta hai, aur Durga se, usko roz dekhti hai. In her, for 8 years, we ran a science club in the school. No other reason, that's the only neighborhood school. No other reason. No political affiliation. This is the neighborhood school. We mustn't. We do it for the whole world, we must make it for one school close by. Durga was said, 4 years back, as part of a school exhibition, she made this morning. This is famous the world over as Durga's Kalpana. And I'll tell you the story, it's worth telling. What she did was put a small bottle, cut out the bottle. So it's like a tube now. This is the lid to make offset a hole in the lid. Put two, you know, two paper pins, so there are two holes, and you put a small turbine. You can see. It's turbine. And if I move this, bottle in this glass water, what would happen? Water will enter. Air will be expelled from the top and will move the top. This is what will happen. The times when you're simply poor, she stood second in high school, I focus in marks. So the times when you printed a photograph and saying, this model, this is Durga's right hand, this guy. And there are very good people in society. 517 checks, more than from 20 rupees to 20,000 rupees. In a written function, Professor Mashek, who was director of the CSIR for 10 years, a Pune scientist, fellow of the Royal Society, and came from a very humble background. Mashek's mother was a housemate. For a very, very appropriate person to give a check to civilization to Durga for this divine machine. Today's input from the best instrument body, she just got efficient. This is the possibility of every girl child. This is something called as a levitating cancer, which we did about 9 years back. These are, you can see six pigmenters, they all come from China, and they go into a pencil very easily. These are embedded in a piece of rubber, it could be a white slipper. Now the first ones are cracked, so they are north south, opposite poles, so they are cracked. The rare ones are similar poles, so they are embedded. Either they are both north or they are both south. So the rare ones are embedded in the pencil. The front ones are opposite poles and they're pulling inside. So if I just put my finger over here, you can see this pencil is actually hanging in there. And I'm just making it very friction. But there's a lot of friction between the pen point and my finger. So we get a piece of steel, old, like this. But this is more than junk. Then we just cut the scissors. It's as smooth as glass, not so harmful. And if you give it to her, it will be very little friction. There's only friction over here, and we have friction. Now this is her name is Mughal, her name is Hamsa Padmanabhan. Her father teaches in Ayuga. The practice is Ayuga has been enforced instituted the awards in basic sciences. His name is Paddy Padmanabhan. Paddy won the first award for philanthropies 6 years back. Well, this daughter, her name is Hamsa. I went to no fancy school, but the case went across the whole nation. She was fascinated by this. And she wrote a 12-page mathematical paper on this. Lifted from Pune to Seattle, second in the international award of $2,000. When she went to the US, the American Association of Physics Teachers was so sad by what this girl had done, we gave another $2,500. If you Google today, our mind on planet is named after Hamsa, the machine's. The potential of every girl in this country. Gone are the days of the colonialists when they said the white man is superior to the brown man and the black man. We could look them in the eye at that. But we must have self-respect and self-worth for ourselves. This is not the not eating humans, shamanism. But we must have respect. We come from a very ancient civilization. This is about the lack kids in my city have made this. Puna is an enormous advertising site. Had I not done Puna, I would not be doing what I was doing. Because one of you might have read Ramchand Bua's book, Make This One Indian, where this great historian provides 19 great Indians who had a major impact on India's development through their thoughts, through their writings. Of these 19, six happened to be from my city. So it's a city which is the most amazing, vibrant city. Gopal Krishna Gokhale, Gandhiji's political guru, you have the five grand Tilak, you have Maharishi Karve, Bharat Ratna, pioneer of women's education. You have Mahatma Phule, the person who first raised the voice of the depressed classes, Tarabai Shinde, Amitabh Bachchan. So this is the city where the very top Maharashtrian middle class, and this has never pervaded to be the UP Gram, because there have never been any movements in 150 years of social movement in Maharashtra, which leave behind the residual marshes, that's amongst the middle class. 100 books have just gone for no money exchange, but you could get to translate it. Okay, this is not the NCRT language, this is our Bharati language, but it's a civic society. And they're a very, very powerful force to reckon with. We must take them on board every time. But a couple of more words, this is not very much full. There's a book, What is the Joy of Making Indian Noise? Written by Sudarshan Khanna, I translated this book into Hindi. Sudarshan Khanna, the Bharati Kiran, for the National Press. He used to teach me, and I've been at the bar for 35 years, and he inspired the students who came from all over India that whenever you go to your medicinal invitations, get all the village boys, get all the Vela boys. And he documented them into a book. And this is a salute to the genius of the nature. Before all these Barbies and He-Man and Stud-Man, all these bloody sexes and violent boys made their way to, when kids in India made their own boys, had fun. But this is what corrupt. This is like a simu for ma, slightly. This must have been managed from Kerala. So the people would pick up a baby coconut and poke it. It's very difficult to find coconuts in at least in Ayodhya. So you take a piece of rubber slipper, poke a hole, and there's supposed to be some baby there. And this is it. Where did the Indian swimmer in spirit? This is Russian tech. Centrifugal force, centripetal force, a very big words for literally. Even people who teach them have no feeling for it. Because these are very abstract forces. You can only understand them through doing, through this process. So there was a kid who got in a walk for this. Now you can see both these stories are structurally quite similar. But look in addition over here that you can see two similar acts. Now this fourth class tenant, right? There's something which spins, which is these similar acts. May the guests of your spiritual imaginations, this can only come from a four-year-old child, right? Because they have a very pliable imagination. For this child, it was a satellite. This Bodhisattva spins around there, and these are the solar panels, which are generating electricity all the time. And he won an award for this. And maybe I might be able to show you something about that. If not, excuse me. Now, this is a delivery hanger, and you just pull it out. So, this is kind of a diamond shape, and this is a quite big one. It's the government of India seal on it, and which is very important. Now it's just being pushed. It's the government who makes it over there, right? And in a true democracy, if you're a true democrat, you must be a nuisance to the government if you're that. That's the definition of a true democrat. You must be a nuisance, because that's otherwise these are power hungry, these people get mad. And it's only civic society, so it's best in a democracy that the people must bring the government on their little fingers. Please listen. I'm not that different from the boys in the cafe. This is independent of my belief system. This is irrespective of my religion. These are forces of nature. This is the force of spirit. And right now you can see my fingers are something. And very slowly. This is how the earth spins around the sun, doesn't fall into the sun. This is the great centrifugal force. This is how the moon spins around the earth and doesn't fall into the earth. Why is it sticking? No prayers, no mantras. This is the spinning. We start there. And not because of a super glue, not because of a super magnet. But this is awesome. Slowly, like of course.
The sun is so small, the heat
is the sun's heat which leads to evaporation water and you get clouds. And once it's clouds, that leads to precipitation, rainfall. And once it rains, all the reservoirs are depleted. And if you had an A4 size paper like this, if it's printed on one side, so much the better, because the printed side is camouflaged. A scale, a plastic scale and a pencil, that's it. And 3 minutes, it just works. No glue, no scissors. It's called a you can see it's a hexagon, flexible hexagon. The outer profile is a hexagon. So if you drop the little part, it's called a hexagon. And we made a film on this about 6 years back. 2 years back, the Polish Academy of Sciences dubbed this film in the Polish. Within a month, there were 500,000 viewers of this film. And this just gets you that why some of the greatest mathematicians that come from small countries like Poland and Hungary. Such an appetite for science and maths. Well, you see, just a year for science paper, you could be in a middle school, you could be in the opportunity school, and you could just keep a stable. And then what you could draw is just limited by imagination. This is not just limited to study science. If you were a good history teacher, you would make history because history is all about timelines. If you were talking teaching the Mughal period, but who's the first Mughal emperor? The broad picture, broad writing, dates, write the name. Who succeeded him? Who exceeded next? The next? That's what we repeat this in the This one is flexing. Very, very beautiful. There are not too many models but this is again one of those very, very, very lovely ones. This is a 14-page unending book. You need 2 squares. 1, 2, 3, 4. You can all see. 5, 6, 7, 8. 9, 10, 11, 13, 14. That's the last page of the book starts again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. It's a very, very clever one. They're two beautiful images we just wrote down. And imagine a child in class 4, class 3. Every child has a favorite story which they like to study. Okay, 50 times, not get all about it. Divide the story into 14 steps and illustrate. So every child has a very dynamic, rotating picture book, which was there. Well, I need one of the volunteers to see to show 2 models. Someone, please, volunteer. Please hold this hand. Now, what I'm holding is essentially a plastic tube. Before you get plastic bags, this is how many bags are made. It's screwed into the tube, and this long tube is cut in one side. See, this is how it can make bags. You can buy the tube itself. We have tied a mark one end. The question is, what is my lung capacity? So I'm going to take a very deep breath and blow my lungs out into the tube. We're going to be about 3.5 liters. Pi r squared is very easy to find out. Now you can see this model. This is made by, it's called. Now this is inside up about 3 meters away, every 2 centimeters we use telescope. On top of it, another layer of tape. So you see, say, 1980s or centuries people there. You hold it hard, don't move.
Okay,
now,
you want to
turn
that so that we can understand?
Yeah, sure. Have you ever seen a reflected ray in life? Right. There is the incident ray, and there is the reflected ray. If you hold it loose, it's like a sloppy old man like me, or walking like that, very slowly, because it crisscross in the medium, it's not crisscross. You hold it back, it's like 60 bits, it goes up and down. Well, now what I'm going to do is I think you can see that what the graph is, what the crest is, if you want to screw, throw a pebble in the middle of the pond, you see this pebble by itself. Just go to the margin, go to the brink, and go to the end. But the water in the middle just keeps bobbing in the middle. It just pushes the water next door. It pushes the water. This is how the force is transmitted. Now you can just see over there. I can cross the message. The message is going from here to there, but these straws are just bobbing around their own respective points. If you give it more twists, the frequency increases, the wavelength increases. If you don't like this, the wavelength is increasing. That would be excellent teaching aid. Maybe class 7, 8, 9, understand about wave motion. Of course, it looks like the wave changes anyway. But because it's so simple, no one does it. And the only hope is not the teachers. I've been gained for teachers all my life. They come from such a mutual aid, not fit for teaching. The only hope comes from children because they are born with this. There is great hope in children. What has kept me alive for 30 years is the gleam in the eyes of the children and the happiness on their faces. This has kept me alive because I see hope in them, for my country, for the world. Not the teachers. The exceptions, the obvious 5% teachers who are motivated for X, Y, Z reasons. But this is the hope lies that children start making them and gifting like me. Through Gandhigiri fashion, you can even decide, madam, this is your service. And this would, this would, and this is the only way out. I think in the end, I'm getting what? Poems like this, we call them toys because we call them science, but we don't call them science. These are toys, they have deep thought behind every experiment, uses some of the humblest, simplest materials, but we call them toys. And that's why we have attained a modern popularity among children. We use very simple, the newsprint. We make a dozen caps. Now this is such a thing because a pretty cap. If you have half a newspaper, you can do all this. And this can be geometry laboratory. Because all the polygons which you talk about in the abstract, you actually folded it. At the end of the day, they make a cap, which if one child has made it, there's a peer pressure. The whole class wants to, no one wants to be left behind, everyone wants to make it. So this is a very accurate cap. This is, of course, we made it for 25 years, and now stole it from us. But this is our national cap, which now for newspaper. But in the end, I'll just tell you one story, which may be near you. This is called as a captain's hat story. अगर आपने कप्तान टोपी शंकर का नाम ना सुना हो तो टोपी शंकर एक पानी के जहाज के कप्तान थे और आपको मालूम है कि पानी का जहाज एक जहाज से दूसरे बंदरगाह में जाता है तो एक सेवन मंथ सेवन वीक्स सेल्स वेरी स्लोली जाता है एयरक्राफ्ट बट देयर वर मेनी पैसेंजर्स ऑन द शिप एंड फॉर द फर्स्ट टू डेज ऑफ कोर्स दे एंजॉय द जर्नी वेरी मच बट आफ्टर फ्यू डेज उस दिन के बाद में ट्रैवल करके क्या दिखाई देता अथाह नीला समुद्र ना कोई दरख्त ना कोई पक्षी ना कोई पेड़ सबके सब They become seasick. Now, Dobi Shankar was the captain, he was a very enlightened captain. He saw that all the passengers were getting bored. So he invited them on the deck. He said, you sing and dance the whole day, and I'll provide you with food and drinks. Dobi Shankar ran to the ship, and he was a Dobi Shankar was in the party, and he was a traitor. Now, this is a huge umbrella. The captain standing on the deck, it protects the scorching sun, protects him from the rain. And he was a very clever man. So at night, when the passenger would go to sleep, he would take the same cap and give it one more fold. And the next day, he would be wearing a new cap. Now, this is like you've seen the fireman. And the spinal cord must be protected from the falling rubble, so they are going to shoot the back. So design a cap, so it's a violence cap. Second is a violence cap. And the second time, you take the same cap, one more fall, and the third day, it would be a shikari cap. It's like explorer's cap, it's like adventurer's cap, three caps. And in a very clever match, on the third night, you would give it two more falls. This is the most famous cap. I come from Pune, many of my friends come from Mumbai. Mumbai is the Bollywood. We make 1,000 films every year, the largest number of films anyone makes in the world, and all our dance numbers, cycle numbers are liked very much across the world. And, but if you've seen any of our Bollywood films, the policeman, the Sipahi, always wears a cap like this, and this one is a Pandu cap. This has been catapulted to international glory. It is such a beautiful cap. Four caps in record order. First is the huge umbrella cap, second is the fireman's cap, third is the Shikari cap. Fourth is the Pandu cap, and you must not take it over because it was after all the captain of the ship. आंधी आ जाती, समंदर में हल आ गया, तूफान आ गया, ऊंची ऊंची लहरें उठ रही, छोटे से जहाज की क्या मिसाल है, समंदर में तूफान आ गया, the ship is rocking and pitching along with the waves, and a huge wave comes and slaps the ass of the ship and knocks it down. जहाज के रुक गए, सारे मुसाफिर घबरा गए, तो हम कितने बनाने आए थे, तो बहुत साक्षात मुंबई सामने खड़े थे, तो एक और आगे से लहर आती है, अगले इसको भी ऐसा टुकड़े The primary portion of the ship is called as a bridge, and a third huge wave comes and knocks the bridge. The ship is broken into smithereens, the ship sinks, and the captain is lost. His wallet, including the suitcase which had all the caps. Kushti bacha ko Vishankar lut jata hai, bachti hai to dekhe ek life jacket.
Thank you. 44 of them. They are going for drill.
Thank you.
Anyway, Thank you. Does it the same thing?
So, and she said you're working with Fujitsu.